We source old whiskeys that you will never be able to get again, and we have them here for you to try. The other whiskeys that we have are single barrels, some that we sourced years ago, some that you can't source. So it's important to denote where whiskey came from. So Old Granddad that's being distilled today, Jim Beam, is not the same as Old Granddad that was being distilled at Old Granddad. Old Crow, Stutzel Weller, say Old Fitzgerald. All of these whiskeys are different depending upon what era and what distillery it was actually distilled at. Well, first, you want to nose it. You want to keep your mouth slightly open so you can get the aromas in them. Now, there's two ways. This is neat. You could also add a drop of water, distilled water. One drop of water will separate the oils, open up the aromas. First of all, we never tell you how to drink your whiskey, but if you want to get the most out of your whiskey, ice is a flavor condenser. It'll shut down your palate. Anything extremely cold. And also, it'll dilute. That's not to say that you don't want to enjoy whiskey on the rocks, because I tell you what, there's certain days that I just want a whiskey on the rocks. If half of my friends say nosing it is the best part, and half of them say drinking it's the best part. Maybe 75, 25, I think. Nosing it, 25. What you're trying here is pre-fire Heaven Hill. So Heaven Hill burnt down in 1996. If you're a collector and we're talking Heaven Hill pre-1996, it's referred to as pre-fire. Each distillery, depending upon the size of the stills and the time period, imparts different flavor profiles into the whiskey. There's a lot more nuance to a cash strength whiskey than there is to a diluted whiskey. When you start diluting, especially bourbons down, I feel like there's a lot less variance. Most people think it has to be aged for at least 2 years. That's a fallacy. It can be aged the shortest amount of time possible. You can literally pour it through the barrel, let it run along the side and out the, and that's technically bourbon. A straight bourbon is at least 2 years old. But because you have those tenets of newly charred oak, at least 51% corn, and then the rest of it is comprised of malted barley for fermentation, and then either rye or wheat. It has to be 51% corn, but the additional grains can be anything else. The reason to have 3,000 bottles or 10,000 bottles is exactly what it is, the nuance of character. And that's why you'll see that the bulk of our product line, or a lot of it, is cask strength, because it has the greatest depth and complexity. Anybody who wants to be successful getting one of these guys to create a cocktail with their spirit is the biggest thing you can do. You'll sell more volume putting it in their hands. You want to drink it neat, you want to be able to sell it on the rocks, but if it's user-friendly in a cocktail, you're kind of the triple threat. This is the time when the average consumer is experimenting with every whiskey, and not just, obviously, if you're a bourbon guy, you're also drinking Scotch, you're also drinking Canadian, you're also drinking Irish. I don't know any whiskey guys right now that are really just like, oh, I only drink single malts. We went from getting everything you could get in the market to then flying to places and getting it shipped in or figuring out a way. I'm not gonna say it on camera how stuff gets around, but I've done a lot of road miles with big trucks to get products. And back in the day, that's what you did. We literally decided to expand based on the fact that we had more whiskey than we had shelf space. And we just really wanted to house all of it under one roof, a place that was the mecca for whiskey people. It's really been the last 3 years that the whiskey market has gone insane. 5 years ago, it was not like this. Old Rip Van Winkle was discontinued, Old Rip Van Winkle 15. You know it now as Pappy 15,
yeah. But
it was used to be in a squat bottle called Old Rip 15. We were finding it in discount dump bins in Kentucky for $23 a bottle. No one wanted it. We charged $9. That same bottle I recently bought at auction for $1,500. That's where the market has hit. Yeah, we got whiskeys that are up to $600 an ounce now, and that people actually have purchased. These are not just for show. We're drinking Few, which is a distillery in Chicago. Paul Heiko is the master distiller and owner of it. If you find a single cask from the 70s, it's generally, I think, an amazing whiskey. Why? Because they had every cask in the world to choose from. Today, these independent bottlers, or people that buy single cask, don't have access. They're getting whatever's out there, as opposed to having hundreds, thousands, tens of thousands of casks to say, this cask is ready to go. Our whiskey advisors are a gentleman who's 23 and Asian, and a 28-year-old African-American girl are two top whiskey people. Does that tell you where the whiskey market is and is heading? Now the average customer coming in knows just as much as you know. And they're just looking for someone to talk about their whiskey. Did you try this one? No, I haven't. Did you try this one? You know, in the old days, you used to come in and I was so happy to have somebody to talk whiskey. If you brought up whiskey, I was probably gonna sit down and drink with you and comp your tab because I wanted to talk to you. Now, people know it, and I actually get to charge you, which is fantastic. This one that you're drinking is a single barrel from Willett. This is a distillery that was run for generations by the Thompson family, but a lot of these old Willett barrels, what they did was they kept bottling contracts with all the big guys. So they had access to all of this extra whiskey, and they also produced some of the best whiskeys ever when they were actually distilling back in the 70s and 60s and so on. but they also saved a lot of barrels that got out to us directly as single barrels from all the distilleries that we get to try today. It's a $1,000 bottle, but we got it because we bought the barrel and we sell it for the appropriate price. You're seeing it from Willett already. You're gonna see it from Peerless in Louisville. Those guys are also harkening back to the old days, aging stuff a minimum of 4 years bourbon. Rye, on the other hand, 2 years. You wanna look for a great whiskey that maybe flies under the radar? 7-year-old Baker's. Baker's is probably an unsung hero of Jim Beam. Booker's was that high proof spirit that people like today. I hadn't been to Maker's Mark for 8 years. All of a sudden they're on fire. Cash Strength Makers 46, Cash Strength Makers, the special stave age stuff that they've got coming out. Willett always has amazing stuff. Heaven Hill was one of the first, the Parker's Heritage Collection. We're moving away from bourbon. We're moving into the category of American whiskey with the Westland, the Northwest part of the country. Westland is doing some great stuff, single malts. So you think, oh, Americans cannot produce single malts? That is incorrect. I think the man who pioneered this would be Fritz Maytag at El Pochero, which you might know Maytag from doing everything great from great beers to great cheese to washing machines. The family touches everything. It's phenomenal. So this is another distillery that will make it through the other side. So here we're gonna add another one. Sonoma Distilling, Westland, Few. Like I said, Willett is just beyond that. Peerless, Bell Mead. The guys that are coming out the other side are the guys that say, I just want to make the best whiskey I can make. I want to make the greatest whiskey ever. That sentence is in common with everybody that I'm mentioning so far. Isla, which is an island off the southwest coast of Scotland. If you're into PD, you're like a diehard. And they have some of the best distilleries, Ardbeg, Kilhoman. But I love these big, bright Bowmores. A lot of peat smoke. We're looking for whiskeys that hit the palate for the individual who's drinking it. So you need part of the people to like it, you need part of the people to think it's great, and you need part of the people to think it's okay. But what you don't want is everyone thinking it sucks. That's it. You want to be in the conversation.